I'll give you now a general description of the integrating factor method, which you should recall is a technique for solving linear first-order ordinary differential equations, and those are the differential equations which have this form, a of x y prime plus b of x y equals c of x, where a, b, and c are some known functions of x. Now, since this will be a general description of the method, I recommend that you go back and watch the introductory video on the integrating factor method so you have an idea as to why we would be doing what we're doing. I'll split this process into three steps, and you can follow these three steps without knowing why they work the way they do. But when we're done, I'll explain why these three steps work to help solve the equation. So the first step will be to rewrite this ODE that we're presented with in what we call standard form. So we want the equation to look like y prime plus p of xy equals q of x. And the way we do that is dividing through by a of x if a of x is not 1. So p of x would be b of x over a of x, and q of x would be c of x over a of x. This is not, you know, a super essential thing, it's just a matter of convenience to use the method. The next step is to compute the integrating factor. So the integrating factor we'll call r of x, and what is it? Well, it's the exponential of any antiderivative of p of x that we choose. So we have this function p of x here in the equation. We compute an antiderivative of it, doesn't matter which one, just choose one, and take e to that antiderivative. That will be the integrating factor. Now, using this integrating factor, we can actually express the solution to the equation. The solution will be given by y equals 1 over the integrating factor times the integral of the product of the integrating factor and this function q of x on the right-hand side. So this is, you can think of this like a formula for a solution. If you want to just use it, you can use it to write down the final solution. But I don't really like to just use formulas with no understanding of where they come from. So let me explain where this formula comes from now. So we start with y prime plus p of xy equals q of x. We compute the integrating factor as I described in step 2. If we multiply both sides of this equation by the integrating factor, we have r of x y prime plus r of x p of x y equals r of x q of x. So all we did was multiply by the integrating factor. Now the thing to notice here is that this product, r of x times p of x, is in fact the derivative of r. And that is by the definition of the integrating factor. We cooked it up in such a way that its derivative, by the chain rule, would come out to be r of x times p of x. Now this right here is the real crux of the argument, because what we notice now is that r of x times y prime plus r prime of x times y, well, that looks like the product rule applied to the product r of x times y. So what we notice is that the left-hand side is a derivative. We made the left-hand side of the equation a derivative by multiplying by the integrating factor. So now we can rewrite the equation as r of x times y prime equals r of x times q of x. Now this, the equation written in this form, we can solve. And we do that by integrating both sides of the equation. So we get r of x times y equals the integral of r of x times q of x. And we solve for y by dividing by r of x. So there's where that formula came from that I said you could just use if you wanted to. But that's where it comes from. It comes from multiplying by the integrating factor, using that to fold up the equation on the left-hand side into a derivative of a product, then solving for y by integrating and dividing by r of x. Let me make a suggestion for you if you felt like this argument was just really, really heavy and just lots of symbols and very confusing. Let me suggest that you go back to the example that I did in the previous, the introductory video of y prime plus y equals 3. And try to mimic this argument with that particular example. Now, let me also give you a puzzle, something to think about. When I introduced the integrating factor a moment ago, I said that you could choose any antiderivative of p of x. It makes no difference which one. Tell me why. Why does it make no difference which one? It sure seems like the integrating factor appears in this equation. So it seems like if I chose a different antiderivative, then I'd get a different solution for y. So the question is, well, why does it not matter which of those integrating factors I choose?